Hello, my friends. I'm International Master Andreas Demnadianos, and today we'll see how the double pawns influence the center. Our examples will be from games of Mikhail Moiseyevich Botvinnik. Hello, my friends. I'm the National Master Andreas Demnadianos. First of all, I would like to thank you because already after 6-7 months I have 1000 subscribers in my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for this. The last 2 or 3 videos I cannot do very often because of the birth of my daughter. Okay, so please understand that the first month will be heavy for me, not so easy to deal with, so I have to do video not every 2-3 days. Okay, so today we'll see how the double pawns can influence the center. I choose to show you 3 games of Mikhail Moiseyevich Botvinnik, so you will understand very easy how sometimes it's very good to have double pawns, okay, but close to the center only. So the first game is between Botvinnik and Panov. It's not easy to find this game. It's not in the databases, in analyzed, of course, but it is in some Russian books. So let's try to see. It is Botvinnik Panov from Leningrad, 1939. Okay. E4-E5 was played and 4 knights. This is an underrated system. With bishop e5. With this opening, I became a champion of Greece under 20 because it's a very good way to avoid too mainstream theory. Okay, because many years ago, of course. Bishop e4 was played from Panov and castle and d3. Now, when white played d3, they have this idea. They can play knight e2 and knight g3. We'll have some Ruy Lopez position, but this bishop on b4 will give us many tempos with c3. Okay, that's why black are obliged to take here. Okay, white took on c3 and d6, bishop g5 and queen c7. This idea with the idea of this move is after we want to play knight d8 is the Rubinstein variation. Akiba played this variation often, and many openings until today have the name of this great Polish player. So, d4 was played, knight e6, and bishop g1. Now, the best move according to theory is c5. The idea is that white cannot take the pawn because of knight c7 and 2-piece army prize. So, in this game, c6 was played. And now, bishop c1. Well, I think something like rook d8 will be normal. But black choose to play knight d7. I don't like this very much. After g3, c5. Now, it was an amazing game, an amazing idea from Botvinnik that also used many years ago Fischer with black against Portins in a Queen's Indian. He took on e5, and now he played this amazing move. But the idea is to play for the f5 or the d5 square. Okay, we understand now that the importance of the d5 square is obvious, because I can later on, after I put the knight on d5, to play c4, and I keep the d4 square with c3. You see the use of the double pawns. Seems very strange, but these pawns are not weak. Weak around pawns when our opponent can attack them. This c3 pawn is not a target for black from now. Let's see, for now. Later, if white continues accurately, there will be no problem for this pawn. So it will be not a weakness, but a very good double pawn in the center. So g6 was played and knight g2. Now, when you see many of you that you saw my videos, you understand that I don't like this kind of moves. Okay, when a piece go back, I say for a joke, 90% very bad move, a 10% a fantastic move. It is not a neutral move. It is normal to play knight b6, to keep an eye on the d5 square, to take the d line. So after knight d7, I think white has a clear advantage. Okay? So, bishop c6 was playing and c4. Now, black is not in a hurry to put the knight on d5. They can play simply, prepare, and after to go to d5. Also, you have to understand that in this position, white has the two bishops. What is the problem when we have the two bishops and our opponent has bishop and knight? The problem is black cannot control the squares that they don't have a bishop. So the dark squares here. So white start to play in the dark squares. Bishop b2, f6. Now, how to continue with white? Botvinnik played f4, a very good move. Okay, trying to open the dark squares. So you can see if you take, this is interesting, to put some pressure immediately. So the knight to have a role on h5, rook f1, but now comes a very strong move e5 and f5. See, this knight is hanging on h5. So after bishop f7, knight g4, and white has a very strong initiative. Okay. That's why after f4, Panov choose to play rook e8. Rook d1 and b6. And I like very much this kind of moves now. Rook d2. It is a multi-purpose moves. Okay. You can choose to double on the d file. You can choose to double on the f file. You can also protect c2 or the second run. It's a very interesting move. And now, black took and play a mistake here. They play g5. Okay. Maybe it's not a good move, but how to continue? See? Now, Mikhail open all the dark squares. Take on g5 and e5. This is a very good move. Now, you see, the idea is to come to d5, play the knight on f6. But according to the computer, this is a much stronger move. Because also can come to d5 and threaten to take first the knight on d7 and after to come to f6. But okay, knight d5 is also strong. Knight h5 was playing and rook f1. Now, knight f4. Queen e4, queen e5, take. If you take with the rook, it's again a problem because after knight c7, you cannot take with the knight because the rook is hanging on a5, and if you take with the rook, the knight on d7 is hanging. So, black choose to take with the bishop, but now he loses a pawn. Check first, he opens the dark squares and take on a4. Okay, the position is very bad for black, we can understand this. Now, the simplest route is to play h3, but okay, rook takes g4 is all winning for white. And now a very good move. You see, a bishop in front of the rook is a very usual theme. There is also an amazing game Karpov here in a Ruy Lopez theme to close a file and to open later. So rook e7 and bishop f8. It was the game because Panov resigns. This is the first game. So we'll understand, it's not a difficult game, but it's a very good game to understand how to use the two double pawns on the center. Let's go to the next one, my friend. The second game is between Botvinnik and Chekhover. Okay, it was in the final of the USSR Championship in Leningrad, 1938. Botvinnik is with white. He played d4. Now we have the Nimzowitian defense, the bishop b4, knight f3. It's a variation that Botvinnik used to play sometimes, and that's why we saw after that Kasparov also, his pupil, used it in a game against Karpov, castle and bishop g5. Now, I have to say the best move is c5 or b6 for me, because castle allowed to play bishop g5. This is a very nasty pin. It's not easy for black to get rid of this pin. b6, e3, and now queen e7. Black wants to have these two pawn breaks, okay? c5 or e5. Bishop e2 and e5. Okay, now we will see that a lot of Botvinnik analysis has some mistakes because of the use of the computers today. But generally the feeling is quite right, of course, because he show us the way he think. Now, it's good that the white played queen c2, because after castle, black can take on c3, and they have this knight e4, and it seems that there is no problem for black. Okay? So, after queen c2, and rook e8, castle was played. Now, after bishop takes c3, the best is to take with the pawns. When you play position with queen c2 on the Nimzoidian, you know that when you take with the queen, all the time you have to think of knight e4 as a very natural move. Okay, if it was played, of course, black will be fine. That's why white took the pawn on h6, bishop h4, and c5. Rook e1 is a very good move. Very amazing that this game was published in many books, according to Botvinnik, with not rook AE1, but with rook FE1. This seems not easy to understand, because white wants to play knight d2 and f4. So there is no point to move the rook out of f1. And it's very strange that no one of the commentators doesn't understood this. Okay, so rook e1, and now, because knight d2 is a threat, rook bishop g4 is a very good move, because if white played knight d2, it's a mistake, because black can take the pawn. Okay, so white has to play something else after bishop g4. So to continue with white, a very good move now came from Botvinnik. White took on f6 and queen e4. Now the best move is to play something like bishop f5. This was afraid. Botvinnik was afraid of this move, because now he thinks that the white pieces lose their cohesion, okay, their coordination. So, but okay, according to the computer, white still have some advantage with e4, but of course it's better than the game. Okay, in the game also bishop c8 has some meaning. Now, after knight d2, the problem is you cannot play knight c6, because f4, bishop e5, f take e5, it's very strong for white. Okay, we see why the rook has to be on f1, also, that there's bishop on f5. But also, black has to play something like queen d8, but the same opening of the d-file, and rook d1 is better for white. Okay, black choose to play a very inferior move. Okay, bishop take on f3 is not good, because now you see all the large squares are very weak. But how to continue this is not easy, because I put this test to many of my students. Okay, only one find how white to proceed in this position. There are many ideas, but not so easy. The best move is to take on c5 and to use the d5 square. Okay, so when you see an open line like this, and you see a pawn targeting one square, this is a very good square to double on this file. Okay, rook d5, a very good move. Of course, black position is not easy, because it has no pawn breaks, it has no easy plan. The only open file is in white's hand. So how to proceed? Black cannot take on d5, because white can take the pawn. Play d6 now, and the position opens in white's favor. Maybe queen e7 is interesting, and I think in all this position, Botvinnik didn't mention, but it is important for black to choose to play g6, to cover some dark squares, to have some f5 and e4 ideas. It will be his best chance. Okay, now, after b6, that was played in the game actually, rook ft1, knight a5, now the best move is not the h3. That Botvinnik. Now there is no comments in this position, because h3 is a very natural move, because protect the first rank, okay, and is ready to go inside black's camp and doesn't want to worry about back rank mate. But the best move here is h4. This is a very strong move, because black wants to play g6, and now h5 is very strong, giving a clear advantage. Right. In the game after h3, I think black has to play this move, keep white advantage to a minimum. In the game, black took on d5, I don't like this move, and now, of course, there is no reason to take the pawn, because black can blockade, there is no time for the knight to blockade, because queen f4 is very strong, but you can blockade it with the queen. And white has some symbolic advantage, but rook takes d5 is much stronger in this position. Now, once more, what to play with black? G6 is the best move. Okay, rook d8, not so good, because you take the e5, and if he take on c4, now he lose after check and queen e4 double attack. So queen e7 was played, and now came an amazing maneuver of Botvinnik. Can you find how to proceed with white? It's important to understand all the position and not to see only one move. Here is a plan of 2-3 moves that help you understand this position. Play bishop g4, that is a move that we can all guess, but not with the right meaning. Everyone wants to play the rook on d7. Okay, but after queen b7 came the right idea from white. He played an amazing move. Bishop f5 for me is 2 exclamation mark. Because protect the queens also has the idea to play rook d7, but also a very strong move is to take on e5. Okay, so it's not easy to play g6, because white can simply take on g6 and rook dx, finish the game. If you play queen e7, f4 is very strong move, because you cannot take because of mate. Okay, that's why black choose to play queen b8. Now, maybe queen d3 is even better, because black does not have the option to play rook d8. This is much even stronger than the game. Botvinnik play rook d7. And now the idea is to play simply check and queen d5. So rook d8 is forced, and white has this very strong. Took take on e5. Black took on c4, exchange queen, and now to understand the meaning of the bishop f5 idea. Bishop e4. There is no reason to take this pawn, because black can organize his pieces. Okay, so after rook take b8, the best move is bishop e4, to put the bishop on d5, threatening the f7, the knight on c4, and also a7 pawn. So knight a3 was played, bishop d5, and e4. Now c4 is not good, because white can take the pawn, can exchange some pawns, but the position is still winning for white because of the a passed pawn. That's why black choose to play a5. C4 now, everything is protected. Black choose to create some pawn break, to do a pawn break on the queen side, have something to play for. But after e5 and f4, now it is time to understand that position is losing. He said checkover after the finish of the game that he thought he had some chances, but after he saw a4, he realized that it's not easy to create any passed pawn on the queen side, and white can simply move his pawns with a5 and e6, create a passed pawn. So now he understood that black's position is knight d4 was played, king f2, g5, g3 simply, knight d6, king. You see also there's a difference between the two kings. The white king is participating in the endgame, and black is just sitting and waiting for nothing. E4, try something, f5. You see, white doesn't have to deal with the c pawn. Just ignore it. E6, take e6. The game was adjourned, but black resigns because there is this check. And very good game for Mikhail Moiseyevich. Let's go to see the third one, my friend. The last video, my friend, is between Botvinnik and Khan in the USSR Championship in Leningrad, 1939 also. So, d4 was played once more, knight f6 and the Nimzo Indian. knight e3. Okay, c5, better move than castle that we saw earlier, and a3. And queen e5. Black tried to do some exchanges. Knight e4. Now, e3 is not so good because black can take on d2. If you take the queen, they can take on d4. Of course, you can go to the endgame with c takes d4, but this is nothing special for white. It has a small advantage, but nothing special. But if you try to use your center, d6 is very strong with the idea of bishop a6. Okay, that's why queen c2 was played. Black took on d2, and knight takes on d2. Now, I think there is also one mistake in Botvinnik comments here. After c takes d4 and knight c6, e3, Botvinnik said that the position is fine for black with e5. This is not true, because after d5, white has a clear advantage. The best is to play something b6 and black has counter chance. And this was the best for black. d6 was played, e3, and now I think knight c6 is the right move. E5 was played, and we see once more that the d5 now is very weak. That's why Botvinnik took immediately on e5, and black took on e5. So, at first, we see that this position, it seems that once more the pawn structure is inferior for white, but this is not true. Okay, the importance of this position is the open d line and the d5 square. Bishop d3 was played with the idea not to make a castle. Now, after g6, not knight e4, as Botvinnik said, but h4 is a very good move because g6 creates a hook. So h6 was played, castle, castle, and now not e4. There is no reason to close the aces from this bishop to the d5 square. Okay? So, after e4, black seems to be doing fine after knight e7. If knight d5 can be played, then bishop take on d5 and transferring the knight to c8 and d6 is fine for black. Bishop e4, it's interesting, but the best move is to play e4. Now, it's very difficult to play the right move here. Can you find how this right move is to take on f4? This is very strange, because now it seems that you open the e-file, but black has resources. After knight d7 and knight f6, white has the initiative, but I think black can keep the position. After knight d7, white has a very strong move, f5. Now Botvinnik doesn't like knight f6, because this piece on f6 always will be obliged to not to move, because he will allow the f6 idea. But after f6, bishop e4 is better for white, without any risk. So knight f6 is not such a bad move. Knight e4 is a very good move, queen d8, and now, of course, we never took a pawn here. Okay, queen b6 is interesting, but also b6 and bishop b7 give a lot of play for black in the c-line. So, after knight d8, white took on f6 and played bishop e4. Now, after rook b8, rook b1, rook d1, b6, a very practical choice. Bishop d5, I don't want to play, because sometimes if I play bishop d5 and he plays bishop b7, sometimes I can take on b7. So, why not in this position to play a useful move? That's why white choose to play h3. So, after h3, if bishop b7, it's interesting, but white can now take immediately on b7. So black choose to play bishop a6, a very interesting move, because they want to play b5 to open a line for counter-attack, because white now has the d line, so black want to have the b line, and after to play bishop b7. Bishop d5 and b5. Now white took on b5. Now, if you take with the bishop, then c4, bishop c6, this is very good for white. Okay, and queen e4. Not take the pawn, because rook e8 gives counter chances, but white has small advantage in this position. Maybe this is what black has to play. He took the rook. And now after c4, white has the advantage. This is very important move, this rook b1. Not to allow black to play bishop b7. I think the best move now is rook b8. White can take. We can understand now that the queen cannot move also from f6, because f6 is very strong. Queen g6 is coming. So you have to take with the rook on b6. Queen a4. Now, if you move the king, this is strong. I'm threatening the pawn on c5. Queen e7. And now f6. Again, this amazing idea. If you take with the rook, I can exchange rooks, check. And queen c6, a very strong move. You have to take the pawn and check. And take the a7 and the f7 pawn. Wins for white. So after f6, black has to choose to take with the pawn. And e4. Okay. White has very good attacking possibilities with queen c3, e3, or queen e1, h4, and white has the advantage. Not king f8, but queen e7 is a better move, but then also f6, cannot take the rook because I take on f6, check and bishop take f7, mate threats, the game is over, so black has to take the pawn, and once more queen c2 is the idea to go to g6. Now, not king g7, because after queen f5, the rook also is coming, but a better move is e4. But also, to give this pawn, just to get some time to transfer the bishop to the defense. But white has the advantage. But this is the best move to choose for black. Rook fb8. Rook d8 was played. And white took on b6. Now, you cannot take the queen, because rook b1 and e4. Clearly in white's favor, so black took with the pawn on b6, and now stop the threat of rook takes d5 and wants to play queen a4. b5 is not possible because you can just take and take the pawn. So rook c8 was played to stop queen a4, but white has time to pass the queen to a4. Okay, now white start to fight the b6 pawn, and black has to, all his pieces cannot move. Okay, also queen b8 is interesting here, but a4 is the best move. Just try to open the b line. King h7, a5, take on a5, rook a6, and take. White is winning, but have to be careful because queen g5 is coming, queen e3 is a very good move, and rook b8, white invade first. Now, after queen a4, a very good move, king h2. So, there is no time for black to play check on the first rank and with the queen and bring the rook also. So, white wins a tempo this way with king h2 first. Now, black cannot come to attack through the g2 squares because queen g3 and rook a1 take and queen d1. White wins here. White match first. Can you find how? After check, very good queen sacrifice, check, check, and mate. That's why black played rook a3, queen c5, rook a2, and now you cannot move because I will change rooks and I play queen e7. Okay, this wins immediately. That's why black played queen a8. Took the rook, but after bishop c6, this is a very strong move because white will take the f7 pawn and the safety of the black king with ideas like f6 give no chance to black. So that's for now. It was a very long video. You can see it in pieces if you have no time, but it's very, very, very useful games. So if you like my video, my channel, you can also donate through PayPal. Thank you. Good day to all of you.